Hey everybody, this is Esteban Gill from Steel and Flint Society, and today we're going to be talking about Lightroom's new feature, texture. Probably the worst thing that could have happened to photography, because we like to overdo the skin stuff and it just looks like we're dolls, and it's probably a terrible idea to do this video, but screw it, let's do it. Alright, so let's get started. So in order for you guys to have this new feature, you'll have to update to the latest version of Lightroom. Then you'll see that there's a new slider here called Texture. I've chosen a couple pictures from a wedding from a few weeks ago. This is Katie and Frank's wedding. And I also tried to choose a different photo that'll have the groom in it as well as the bride, so that we can see how it affects both of them. So texture, let's talk about texture. It's a brand new feature and it's comparable to something called portraiture, which is a very popular app that a lot of wedding photographers tend to use on their photos. So my personal opinion is that I'm not the biggest fan of skin retouching unless it's to get anything out that doesn't belong in the face, whether it's a pimple or maybe a bruise or maybe a piece of hair or so, but I typically don't take it any further than that. But again, that's just my personal preference. If you do like to do skin retouching, I think this is a feature that you can benefit from. So let's work on Katie here. So for this particular photo, I'm gonna go to 1:1 so that we can see some of the changes happening. This was taken with my favorite lens, the 58mm at 1.4, 1/1000th of a second, ISO 100. And the first thing that I want to do is I want to edit my photo with whatever preset I'm using. So as everyone probably already knows, I enjoy using Small or Soulmate. For this particular photo, I'm going to use Small. And one thing that I do like to do with Small is I like to take the grain out. So in order to do that, I'm going to scroll all the way down to the grain slider, which is down here in the effects. And just bring down the grain all the way down to zero. Let's go back to 1:1 view so that we can see the effects happening in real time. So what I'm going to do in order to retouch your skin by using the texture slider, I'm not just going to take the slider and bring it down, because what that does is it actually affects the entire image. So I just want to focus on her face or any other parts of the body that I want to retouch. As far as numbers, I'm at -65 and it doesn't look good to me. I don't think it looks natural, but some people prefer this and I just personally don't. So I found that anywhere from 30 to 40 is a good number for these, but let's bring it down to 30 and you can see the changes. That looks way more natural to me. So let's bring it down to zero and I'll show you how I would edit this. So I'm gonna take my brush, click on my brush, and I'm actually gonna brush her face. If you don't have show selected mask overlay, select that so you can have an idea of where you're brushing. Now, as you can tell with the mask overlay, I am definitely not staying within her face. And that's something that I'm doing on purpose. So in order for me to fix that, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna scroll down and I'm gonna go to range mask, which is this feature that I've talked to a few people in the past couple of days and a lot of them didn't really know that this was something that you could do. So go to range mask, go to color, take this droplet tool and click right on your subject's face. And it's actually going to detect that same color within that portion that you brushed, and it'll actually gives a pretty accurate selection of where you should be retouching based on what you brushed before. So it doesn't select the eyes, doesn't select the mouth, and it does a really good job at separating that from the hair. So Once you do that, you can change the strength. So you can go to amount anywhere to 100, and then you could go down to zero, and then you could tell that it's only gonna affect some of the areas that you selected. So I think 50 is pretty good. You could even go to 60 if you wanna get a little bit closer to the skin that you're selecting. But once you go into the 60s, you can actually tell that it's affecting the eyes a little bit. So I think 50 is a pretty good number for this. So that's the color range mask. The next thing that you're gonna wanna do is just unselect the show selected mask overlay. And that's when you're gonna start to be able to make any changes to the selected mask that you just brushed. So obviously you can do any type of changes. You have exposure, contrast. If you have any changes from the past brush, just double click on effect. And then this is where we're gonna be using the texture mask, the texture tool. So like I said before, 20, 30, no, I would say no more than 40 would be pretty good. So I'm gonna bring it down to let's say 36. And that actually looks pretty good. Now, if you wanted to take a look at and see what the difference is, you could actually see a pretty good change in the skin. You zoom in so you can see. So if you look right on her cheek, let's see how it affects the texture. So it still looks like it cleans it up a little bit while still retaining a good portion of the texture. So that's basically what it does. You definitely, like I mentioned, you don't want to go overboard and make her look like a doll. So I would suggest just going to in the 30 to 40 range, which still gives it that natural look. All right, so we'll go to the next image. We'll do the same thing. Small one. We're gonna bring our exposure up a little bit. That looks pretty good. Now we're gonna do the same thing. We're gonna go to our brush. And we're just gonna start brushing. And you can show selected mask overlay. You can see that both their faces are selected. And once you do that, that's when you can go to your range mask, go to color, and select the dropper tool, and click on her face. And now it bases it on where you brushed, and it sees the contrast and where it should select and not. And again, it does a pretty good job at it. So go to your, change your strength if you wanted to. Like I said, 50 is pretty good. And then once you have that selected, you're gonna uncheck the mask overlay box, and then you're gonna make changes. So now you go into your texture, and I'm at 48, and that looks pretty good too. I'm gonna zoom into 2:1 so you can see the change. Now there's actually, I forgot to take off the grain on here, so let's take the grain off so you can see more drastic change. So that's with the brush at 48. This is with it at 0. So if you look down here and even where his face is, you can see a pretty significant change. It's subtle, but it still shows a significant change in the texture of the skin. So I think it's pretty pleasing, especially when you keep it at that those lower numbers. So if you were to go all the way down to 100, then you're dealing with this fake look, which I've never been a fan of. So let's zoom out so you can see what it would look like at 100 or negative 100. Yeah, not a fan of that. But if I select a texture down to, let's go 39, then it looks more natural. And this is what it looked like before and after. Looks pretty good. I actually really enjoyed doing it. Again, I'm not the biggest fan of skin retouching, but I think this gives it enough of a subtle change where I might start using it. So great, that's pretty much it. Let me know if you guys have any questions in the comments. Make sure you guys subscribe. And if you guys haven't joined our group, it's Steel and Flint Society Wedding Photography Education on Facebook. We have a great deal amount of stuff going on in there, so please join and participate in the conversation. Thank you guys. This is the last time I'm recording this bullshit. All right, so let's get started.